This behavior is unacceptable. We will be having to suspend you for 3 weeks. Now, I hope you take that time to think about what you've done and maybe reevaluate some of your life choices, all right? Do I make myself clear?
Can I go now?
So, what's the verdict?
Out of school suspension for 3 days.
Dude, that's like the second time this year.
Third, actually.
With you, it's like a revolving door. You come out on one end just to start right back where you were the next day.
Actually, I was gonna take this time to really center myself and really focus on my studies.
Oh, piss off, Eric. So, are you gonna tell me what you did?
Nope.
Why not? The principal gets to know, but I don't. What does that say?
It says that it doesn't fucking matter enough for you to know. I'd still be suspended either way. It still wouldn't matter either way, and I still wouldn't tell you either way.
Okay, well, it's gotta sting at least a little bit that you're suspended so often and you don't have anybody to talk to about it.
Honestly, not really.
Okay, well, I wanna know, what fuels your fires?
First of all, never use that analogy again. And second, I guess, just the little things.
Okay, so what are the little things?
I've been talking to someone.
Eric has a someone. Okay, what's this someone's name?
Cleo.
Cleo? As in Cleo fucking McKinnon.
Do you know any other Cleos that go here?
Okay, well, how did this all start?
I don't know, it was all kind of just standard.
Okay, nothing is standard about Cleo McKinnon.
Well, we've just been messaging back and forth on Snap, and I don't know, nothing really that nature.
Okay, so what do you talk about?
I don't know, I guess she kind of talks and I just nod my head and listen.
Wow, so romantic.
Hey, fuck off, okay? If she has something to say, then why wouldn't I let her say it? I mean, I don't think asking her out would cheer her up that much.
You haven't even asked her out yet?
Well, if her and I were going out, I wouldn't be hanging out with you, buddy.
I just assumed she rejected you or something. Like, you're telling me you have the chance to talk to Cleo McKinnon, and you still haven't asked her out?
No.
Why not?
Because I figure that she gets asked out by every dickhead and douchebag every 5 seconds, so why would I add to the bunch? I mean, I gotta stick out somehow.
So you're telling me you're not a dickhead or a douchebag?
I guess we'll have to see.
'Cause he gets up in the morning, then he goes to work at 9, then he comes back home at 5:30, gets the same train every time. 'Cause his world is built on punctuality, it never fails. And he's all so good, and he's all so fine, and he's all so healthy in his body and his mind. Well-respected man about town, doing the best thing so conservatively. And his mother goes to meetings while his father pulls the mane, and she stirs the tea with counselors while discussing foreign trade. And she passes looks as well as bills at every suave young man, 'cause he's all so good. And he's all so fine, and he's all so healthy in his body and his mind. He's a well-respected man about town.
Suspended again? Eric, I thought we had this conversation. What are we going to do to actually have you listen to me?
It's nice to see you too, Dad.
This is not a goddamn joke, Eric. You could get expelled. I don't feel like searching for another school.
It's not a big deal, Dad. I mean, the worst they can do is keep suspending me. They're not gonna expel me or anything.
Eric, how is this a good thing? You've been at school less than you've been at home.
What does it matter? You're at work anyway.
Yeah, but the problem is, when I'm at work, I'm thinking about you. And when I'm thinking about you, I'm not getting my work done. It's not a rocket science. And number two, you know what? I went to school so that I could go to work. I don't get what you don't understand here. But do you see that what I'm getting at?
To be honest, not really.
You're getting a job. You're gonna get your shit together.
Dad, I...
No excuses. Honestly, you're gonna find something. And if you have trouble finding something, you're gonna be cutting lawns, you're gonna be babysitting, you're gonna be helping old ladies cross the street. I don't really give a shit. Either way, you're gonna get off your ass and do something with your life.
I'll go get the mower.
Can I move your lawn? And Sundays pass on by. I'll be working here forever, at least until I die. Damn if you do, damn if you don't. I'm supposed to get a raise next week, you know that when I won't.
Hi, how are you, Ron?
Working for a living. Working for a living. Never had a working.
I'm taking what they give,
cause I'm working for a living.
Totally guilty. No. I was just going around door to door mowing lawns.
Wow, a working man. That's classy.
Oh, I know. I'm kind of killing it in the business department.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I made a whole $5, so I was thinking about retirement soon. So what do you do in the backyard?
Funny you should mention it. I was actually about to mow the lawn.
Oh, really? Well, you have fun with that.
Oh, come on, seriously, I will pay you a whole $10.
Okay, now that you mention it, that is really tempting. So I accept.
Are you gonna stand up there the entire time?
I'm just making sure I get my money's worth.
Okay, I can guarantee that you're gonna get top dollar service and that you will not regret paying for said top dollar service.
Oh yeah? How long have you been in the lawn mowing business?
Ever since my dad told me to earn a living, so I gotta start somewhere.
Did he kick you out, or...?
No, he just told me to pick myself up, you know, the usual spiel.
What'd you say to piss him off?
It's not really that important.
Well, alright, I'll leave you to it then.
Oh, okay, so when I'm done, I'll let you know, and you can judge me as harshly as possible.
Sounds good to me.
What does hmm mean? Did I kill it or did I kill it?
It's satisfactory.
Satisfactory? Seriously? Honestly, I think you're just embarrassed that I did a better job than you ever could.
Oh, please. This is fine at best. But I guess you still did it.
Hey! Would I be able to get a tip?
In your dreams. Hey! We'll talk later.
Cool.
Cool.
barely been an hour.
Well, I guess I just thought I made a satisfying amount, so I'll pick right back up tomorrow.
Well, how much did you make?
$15.
Well, better get back out there.
No.
I beg your pardon?
That I told you, I made a satisfying amount of money and that I will pick up right back where I left off tomorrow. And is that cool?
No, it's not cool. I told you to get your shit together. And I told you not to take this lightly.
I'm not taking it lightly. I just said that I would pick it back up tomorrow.
I don't want to do this right now. No. You're not going to leave this behind as well.
What do you mean, leave this behind
as well? Oh, come on. You know exactly what I mean.
No, I don't, Dad. So please, fucking indulge me.
You watch your mouth.
I'm sorry, Dad. Okay, I apologize. Now, you have the floor.
I'm not playing games with you.
And I'm not playing games with you either, Dad.
You keep this up, you're going to be nothing in your life. I'm serious.
How could you say that?
Don't be so melodramatic.
Start now about the whole melodramatic spiel about how
you're
you have a dramatic
being
son.
A moody teenager.
Oh, okay, Dad. Yeah, you think
I
I'm a moody teacher? Yeah,
best.
Yeah, okay.
I've been trying as hard
you're
as I can.
You're trying your best, okay? You're
you
at work
what?
90% of the time,
God,
you know.
You're flipping burgers for the rest
oh,
of your
life. Oh, now you're going
life.
With the whole generic McDonald's speech.
You're
you know, you're
my time.
Shut the fuck up! How do you know that, Dad? Like, what moment in your life has ever pointed you to the fact that I'm a piece of shit? And secondly, if the only thing that you know about your own son is that he's a piece of shit, then what have I been doing knowing me my entire life? I mean, isn't a father's job to pick their son's elf and set their sons up and not knock him down in the meantime? I mean, not once have you ever asked. I mean, the only thing you've ever done is sit high and mighty and tell me to pick myself up, but what if I don't know how to pick myself up, Dad? I mean, what if I don't know how to get there? But how would you ever know? Like, not once have you asked if I'm all right. Not once have you ever asked if the other kid deserved it. Not fucking once have you ever asked if I needed my dad to tell me how to get there.
Hey.
Hey, Dad.
Where are you going?
I'm going out.
You know, well, what I said earlier, I don't really know what I was talking about. And you know I'm here for you.
I know, Dad. I'm sorry I lashed up.
Cool. Where are you going again?
Date, Dad.
You're gonna make a great impression.
Thanks, Dad. What did you do today?
Well, just helped my little brother with his math homework. That's about it.
You good at math?
I'm all right. I'm not crazy good or anything, but it's enough to get by.
Very cool. What do you do on a daily day?
Well, usually a little bit of reading, maybe some writing. Studying. To get it all done, sometimes I'll watch a movie with the family.
Cool. It's cool. Very cool.
How was your day?
Well, other than getting suspended, it was fantastic.
What did you do to get suspended?
I got in a fight.
No shit.
Yeah, I did.
Did you start it?
No, I finished it. I started it.
What? Really?
Yeah, well, in a way, we both kind of started it. See, a couple years ago, my mom passed away. So it's just been me and my dad for a while. So he pays for everything we got. So kids start talking shit, asking how I can afford the clothes I wear. Dad's paying for everything. So right there and then and there, snapped. Clocked him, he hit the floor. I mean, I expected us to exchange a couple blows, and I'd feel better afterwards, but none of those really came true. Every time I think I'm gonna feel better after I do what I do, I'll be the hero and then my own little story. It's never really the case. Instead, I kind of just think of how disappointed she'd be. Like, every time I think it's gonna be different.
And what do you think you can do to make it different?
What?
What do you think you can do to make a difference?
I don't know.
I mean, what would make you happy? I don't need an answer from you. I just think that before you have a reaction to something, just think, what would make me happy? Because Eric, the most important person in your life is you. And you have to remember that. And for the record, your mom is not disappointed in you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for accepting the date.
Anytime. I'll see you around, Eric.
That I had before. I know things have been hurrying since I came through your door. It's the same questions that I had before. Can I just make it easy? Can I run anymore? Maybe all I need is a little motivation. If I want it, I can have it. If I want it, I can have it. Maybe all I need is a little motivation. If I want it, I can have it. If I want it, I can have it. It's the